Hey YouTube, this is Mayor. Just giving an update about what's going on. Nothing much, just resting. Had a lot of company today, and they left some good energy. My daughter-in-law really enjoyed her visit. But I was watching the news, and our boy, Damar, man, they moving him out of the hospital and taking him back to near his home. So I am so happy that he is seem like he's gonna be okay. Thank God for that. I was thinking about him. He's so young, and I can just about imagine his NFL career is over. He hadn't been in there that long, hadn't made a whole bunch of money because he was a 6th round draft pick. But God will provide. I'm just glad that he's alive. But maybe he can get some endorsements or something, but we can just about believe his career is over. Football career, but he got the rest of his life, hopefully. So anyway, thank God for that. When I first made that video about him, I was angry with I'm not gonna say the man's name anymore, but I know who I was upset with. I was so upset because I know that football is a dangerous sport, and living is just dangerous, you know. But my oldest son, he played football since he was 7 years old. Started out in Pop Warner and had plenty of concussions and all that kind of stuff. And the college that he graduated from, SMU here in Dallas, they were given all the players free MRIs to see if they didn't have that, they had that CTE brain damage. And my son did have symptoms of that, but it's the only way you can find out if you're dead and they examine your brain. So he told me, he said, "Mama, if I got it, I got it. That's just it." But he died from something else. But it's dangerous. Playing sports is dangerous. But I'm still apprehensive about just different things, and people take things the wrong way. And the man that I addressed the video to, it was for him, not for all these other people that came in chiming in and saying all sorts of ugly things about it without even, I don't even think they listened to the video. But I'm so glad because I was very angry, and I made a video that was just, man, I'm doing all the cursing and I was just so furious. And I did make that video, and when I listened to it, I said no. But I felt better after I said all those things. But I calmed down enough to make a short video to get my point across. But everybody got their own way to God. Everybody worships their God, and their God tell them what their God want them to know. So this man, his God, he said his God talked to him in numbers. So be it. My God doesn't do like that. So I guess we got different different gods. I don't know. Maybe so, because my God don't talk to me like that. I'm glad he don't either, because I don't have time to be walking around with a calculator, pen, and paper in my hand all the time. My God just tells me what's what. That's that. Very seldom does he even re he she. Because my God talks to me in my own voice. That's what I hear, my voice. That's how my God talks to me. And very seldom do I hear a repeat. Now, if it's something that's really, really important, my voice will say, "Didn't I tell you something?" And I'll say, "Oh, shoot, sure did." And it ends up saving my life. So that's my communication with my God. And I'm glad my God didn't make it hard for me and give me clues and codes and colors. No, that's too much work. So my God is just to the point, and I'm thankful for that. So, but everybody, play with their God the way they want to. But because evidently it is people God is different, you know, because everybody's different on this earth. Nobody, no two people are alike. So a lot of people say, no, God's got the same rules for everybody. It don't seem like that's true, because you know, if you take this parable, I'm looking at the TV, it's doing something crazy. This parable in the Bible where these people, Jesus made a parable where these people had been working in the fields, they've been working hard all day, and they knew it's gonna get paid at the end of the day. But then here come late on in the evening, here come some more people to work, and the day is almost over with. And the Lord was gonna pay these Johnny come lately, they were gonna make the same amount of money. And the ones that have been there all day toiling, they said, no, that ain't fair. You can't, you either give us more money or pay them less, you know. But this God, the Lord, he's the one that decide what who gonna get paid what. If you come in early or late, it's him that's doing it. So I can't tell you what your God should pay, or my God, or your God. It's none of my business. So, but I do know that there is a difference in how we perceive God. I'm gonna give you all this little parable, and this is a true story. And like I say, if you know God, gotta talk to you where you can understand it. This happened about, oh, near the year 2000. So that's 23 years ago. My sister and I had a house with a big, long country porch. We're sitting on a porch in our little rocking chairs. And in front of the porch were a lot of bushes, you know, just bushes. And I was sitting there. My sister was sitting about 10 feet away from me. And I saw a lizard in the bush, you know. And the lizard was lime green. That's why I was looking at him, because if it had been any other brown, I wouldn't have noticed it. I said, oh, that's a lime green lizard. And my sister noticed I was staring at something. She said, Mary, what you looking at? I said, girl, it's a lime green lizard in the bushes over here. And she said, really? So she started looking, peeping, and trying to see the same lizard, the lime green lizard. She looking. And I pointed. And she said, well, I see a brown lizard right about there. I said, a brown, are you sure? Yeah, it's brown lizard. I said, well, I don't see a brown lizard, but it's a lime green one right here. So she said, girl, let's switch seats. Let me sit over there and see if I see it. So we switched seats. And like I said, it was about 10 feet apart. So I sat in her seat and she sat in my seat. And she said, oh, I do see a lime green lizard over here where you sit. And I look, I said, I see the brown lizard. And we just said, well, it ought to be two lizards here. And then all of a sudden, the lizards started moving. And I saw the brown lizard start turning green. And she saw the green lizard start turning brown. She said, Mary girl, we're looking at the same lizard. I said, we sure are. And sure enough, it was the same lizard. So we just kind of let it go. But while I'm sitting there, my voice says to me, that lizard is the way God is. I sit there, I say, really? And I say, explain that to me. And the voice explained that God is God, but it depends on where you're sitting, but it's still the same God. But he God just kind of like a chameleon. God will be whatever you want him to be. Just depend on where you are. what chair you're sitting in or where you are in your life. But God knows how to be what we need him to be. So, but that's what that parable is about. But I saw that and still don't understand it. How did lizard do that? And what difference did it make where we were sitting? Because the sun wasn't shining on the bushes for the lizard to change color. I don't know. That's a baffling me. And I don't know. But anyway, that's the little parable for today. So everybody, just depends on where you are in your life, how God presents himself to you. He might show you a bunch of numbers, and then you people that's got to follow somebody. If I go sit, be still, and you'll see what your God is trying to show you, because you'll be just as lost as forever. You'll be trying to. My sister would have been. I would have been lost trying to look for a brown lizard. She would have been lost. We've been arguing about the color of the lizard and blah blah blah. But we had to continue to trade places so we could figure that out. That is the same lizard. So keep looking up and don't be afraid. Okay, bye.